Hi, and this is a follow-up to one of my last videos around how to handle retries and failures with Apache Kafka. So following my last video, I've had a lot of questions on how to keep the ordering of events, because that's important. So in this video, I'm going to take you through an approach which I've used where I've been able to keep the ordering consistent, even though I've implemented retry topics and dead letter queues to actually retry. If you haven't already, go watch the first video. So let's say you get an event in and it's customer created. Now, if that fails, you could just publish it to a retry topic without doing anything. But then what happens then if you get another event for the same customer, but it could be billing details edit. Now, if you still haven't processed the customer created event yet, you can't process that one until you've fixed and remedied the first event. So what I've done previously, which worked well, is if I can't process an event, I've logged it into a persistent data store table. And within that database transaction, I've recorded that I can't process that customer or that business entity object with the identifier and that consumer index. So what index was that message at that point in time? You need to keep state of what you can't process. If you suddenly get the later event coming in, your processor needs to do a lookup and saying, in my state table, have I currently got any failures? And if I have failures, like what customer ID am I unable to process? And if that event comes in with the same customer ID, you're gonna say, okay, I can't process you right now, I'm waiting. So what do you do in that case? Do you publish it to a retry topic for later on? Probably not. What I've done previously is actually record that event into a holding queue table inside the database. And then at the point in time when you actually successfully process the first failed event, you can then republish all the events you've gotten after the fact to a retry topic, making sure the ordering is consistent, and then processing it in the same way. So perform the check. Is it currently blocked? No, okay, try. And if one of those events fail, then do the same thing. Mark it as failed and put that lock in place. So the next event what comes in, it knows it can't process. It puts it to the holding queue. It acknowledges the topic and it moves on to the next event. And then again, when you successfully process it, you go in and republish all the events. And that's an approach I've used to keep ordering consistent. Now, I hope you like this video, and please smash that like button and click subscribe, because there's a lot more event-driven architecture videos coming your way, as well as API design videos.